Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Stream Many Things. I am Wheeler, your host for tonight, and tonight we are mini painting and, dare I say it, chilling. But before we get to that, a few quick things to get out of the way. If you aren't already, please follow the channel. We're trying to get to 500 followers by the end of the year. We'll see if that happens. If you have the financial ability to, please consider subscribing. It helps us out. I was able to get a new monitor with the money that we got, so I don't have to futz with things as much anymore or use my phone. Follow us on our socials at StreamofMT on TikTok, Instagram, and Twitter. Mostly active on Twitter. Trying to get more active on other things. I appreciate you, Rob. Thank you for being here. Join our Discord. Link should be in chat right now. Trying to get that a little bit more up so we can have more conversations just about the community and things overall. But other than that, I think that's it. Don't forget that you can cheer bits, you can tip if you would like. It's not necessary, but it does, you know, it does help upgrade the stream and help me get things. If you hear a sound like a fan in the background, it's because I'm 3D printing something right now, and it's almost 3 days into its print, so I don't want to stop it. But with that said, let's go ahead and jump right into it. So I'm doing the Monstrous Centipede from Loot Studios. From this month's subscription, which was the Crimson Sand Arena. And it looks pretty cool. I had it last week, but I unfortunately had internet issues, so we weren't able to paint it, but I wanted to still paint it, so this is what we're working on this week. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to paint the base with this technical paint, which is like a sand. And I know I should be using an applicator, but this brush is specifically used for applying technical paints, so because I want this to dry so I can get a dry brush on it with a lighter color to give it more of a sandy look. Because right now it definitely looks like dark sand. But this is the Armageddon Dust by Citadel. I used it on the Dragon Turtle base when I painted that. But I wanted to get it on here first so it had an opportunity to dry. That is something. So that way I could dry brush over it with a lighter color. Later on, once the centipede is done. And for the pillars, I'm gonna do or attempt to do like a marble. See how that turns out. And I want to be careful not to do too much of this because the centipede still has to go on here, so. Hello, hello, welcome in. I just started, so you haven't missed too much. But we're also gonna do the speed paints on this one, because I kinda wanna try them out again in different colors. Because I've got a bunch of contrast paints, but I got the Army Painter speed paints. Yeah, Rob, tell me about speed paints, or not speed paints, frameworks, because it seemed like you were stoked about it, which means it's probably pretty good. Going to be doing this bone color on the centipede as well. It's pallid bone. I just want this to be brown beforehand. and kind of have the shading semi-done. So I can just dry brush over this at the end and actually, you know, finish a base for once. Also, be on the lookout. I'm probably going to do another one of those community goals again to paint something big, so. I mean, hey, hell yeah. Everything I've seen of them so far has been, like, people actually enjoy them, so. I'm glad that they've done something right with their minis that they're releasing. Not that they don't normally do things right, but, you know. But the orcs looked cool. I saw the kobold. The kobold looked really cool. God, why do I have to have metal dice? My week's been pretty good. Honey's out of town right now, in Florida, so I have the house to myself, but it's been a little boring, if I'm being honest. I might go see a movie tonight or something just to do something. I want to go see the new Fantastic Beasts, see how our boy Mads Mikkelsen did as Grindelwald. Also, if you didn't see my Twitter, we caught a jumping spider in the house, and I worked on an enclosure for it this past weekend. And it actually turned out pretty good, so. Oh, I've seen No Way Home. We've seen it twice now. It was a great movie. I agree with you. It kind of hit me, like, right in the nostalgia. Especially growing up with, like, all of those movies. No, it's not weird that you want to fight Doctor Strange. I won't go see it, Ro, if it makes you uncomfortable. I absolutely won't. I definitely don't want to give money to J.K. Rowling because she is a fuckass. There's some other movies I can go see too. I'm excited for Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness for sure. I know a lot of people are looking forward to it. I think that the interchangeability will be pretty good on it. I don't see them being stingy about pieces. But I mean, we'll just have to see. Let me know how it goes, because that will... I finally have some actual pieces of stuff, like tools that I can use to work on sprue miniatures, because I picked up a tool set. So yeah, that's the whole thing. It's like, oh my god, the Harry Potter game looks so cool, but like super anti-Semitic and fucking awful, so sorry about it. I'll just have to watch other people play it, because I don't want to deal with that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Let's see what else is out. I thought there was something else coming out. Or maybe I'll just have a cool night in and watch The Batman on HBO Max. See it again. Yeah, it's just like the more people hear about like the wizarding world, the more people are like, oh, this is not great. It's like people are like, but why can't I get away with being a bigoted piece of shit? And it's like, well, I think you just answered your question by asking the question. All right, I think that's good on the pallid bone. So I'm actually gonna go red with this. I was looking up a bunch of they really like blindfolded a bunch of kids into thinking that this shit was good, and it's really not. Which sucks, because there's a lot of kids who are like, that's fair, I could do it. Technically, I wouldn't be paying for it anyways. I get free movie tickets because I'm part of the club thing, but what I was saying was, I'm going to do red on this because everything that I've seen on Centipedes is that they're like kind of red. So I wanted to do red for it. So I'll make my own game with wizards. Also, Rob, if you have not tried out the Army Painter Speed Paints yet, I highly recommend it. They are phenomenal. Make things like super tabletop ready in like zero time. And they have been the crutch of my painting recently. Yeah, I hope it comes out one day that, like, she was just the face of Harry Potter, and she didn't even write it, because that would make my life just so much better. And then we could shit on another person for being fucking awful. Funny enough, when I first started reading Harry Potter, I didn't like it. I was like, this is boring. And it was at my grandparents' house, which is even weirder because my grandparents are like super conservative. Or were. Speaking of D&D, I gotta work on a couple maps for my Tuesday night game because I have, like, nothing prepared. Because I've been so busy. Yeah, I was that way with Percy Jackson. I remember when I got the first book, I got it for Christmas, and my aunt also gave me a $25 gift card to Barnes & Noble, and I was like, Dad, I finished the book this morning. I need you to take me to Barnes & Noble so I can get the next books in the series. And he said, you read the whole book? I said, yep. He's like, how late were you up till last night? I was like, 2 a.m. You know, casually as a 14-year-old. My bedtime was like so much earlier than that. Yes, actually I am, because I need someone to do the series actual justice and not make a movie just for profit, because my God, if that movie wasn't just absolute garbage. But that might just be me. Also, if you guys aren't hype for me getting absolutely fucking blasted on Wednesday and playing Hollow Knight, you need to be. Because I know there is so much more left in that game that I am like, I'm not going to go to the final boss until I do it. So... careful with this just so I don't get any red where it's not supposed to be, but honestly it's all gonna blend in pretty heavily anyway, so look, you work at a dispensary, you get free weed, you gotta use it at some point. What better time to use it than 420? Playing video games that have me getting frustrated more than I need to be. I am also excited for that. Because I will be absolutely blitzed. And that's always fun.
Stay thirsty. So I'm doing
this in red, and then I'm probably gonna go back over with a lighter color that's like a tan to kind of bring out the natural centipede color that they stay at. Because I want it to be, you know, at least a little lifelike. I'm so excited. Next month's loot, they gave us a sneak peek of it, and it is so cool. I'm gonna print off literally everything. What I'm printing off on my 3D printer right now is actually finishing the pirate ship from March's loot. So I'm on the third layer out of, I think, five, but it is definitely coming together, and it looks so cool, and I'm so excited to paint it. That might be something that I do on stream. We'll see. I'll just do it off. To the gym today, so I'm a little mostly hydrated, but it never hurts because it is dry as hell out in Colorado, let me tell you. No, we already talked about this. You weren't here. Chris made that joke too. And I was like, abso-fucking-lutely not. Especially not because it's got literal sand in it right now. Actually, I'm probably going to be making a, because Stream Elements lets you make, like, merch. I'm probably going to make one of those Don't Drink This mugs. You know, just in case I forget. Is a little low. I feel like it's easy for people to get that. That'd make it difficult. Maybe like 50k.
don't think any of these are toxic, as far as I'm aware. I mean, I constantly put the brush in my mouth when it has paint on it, so... So once I'm done with this coat, I'm going to do a... Pretty much everything else is going to be dry brushing. I might have to let this dry a little bit, so I'll go back to the base. Do like a dry brush of a reddish brown on the carapace, and then of like a fair skin or something on the underbody. Miss anything? Yeah, I missed some of the pallid bone, so let's go back to that. Whoops. Okay. I need a thinner brush for this one. Let that dry for a little bit. Ooh. this out. We'll do skeleton bone, and then probably... I'll do skeleton bone and fair skin on the... Fair skin is the highlight on the underbelly, and then skeleton bone and lawful white. Hell yeah, I wish... We've got stuff that we've got to do. Honey just got some stuff in for their Black Cat cosplay that they're doing. And I'm going as yours truly, Peter Parker. It should be fun. Some other stuff I want to work on, like my outfit for the Ren Fair. But. Like comic book Peter. I want to do like my camera and like a nerdy shirt with the costume underneath. Oh, yeah, I love Andrew Garfield. I know, like, Tom Holland's a good Spider-Man, but I think Andrew Garfield is a great Spider-Man. And I also think Tobey Maguire did a good job, too. Seeing is the fact that he was the first, like... Yeah, he definitely caught Honey and I in our feels. Definitely not dry yet, so I'm just gonna chill out. I've only been at it for 30 minutes, so how's everyone's week? Yeah, I think he was just too good of a blend between everything. I personally liked him. But yeah, it's just preference at that point. I like all of them for different reasons, but maybe while I'm at it, I'll work on that. Base for this. The Sphinx that I still haven't worked on. Bases. I've worked on the Sphinx, I haven't worked on the bases. Hell yeah! It's always nice to spend time with your partner, especially if they're away from you most of the time. Like I said earlier, Honey's gone and there's just like nothing to do around the house.
Yeah, I think part of it was just not wanting to redo the same old, like, origin story, but... Hell yeah, though, Ro, I'm happy for you. You should tell him to come out and watch me get fucking blitzed on Wednesday and play some Hollow Knight. God, if you thought my platforming skills were bad before. Whoops. Ooh. Yeah, I honestly... Miles would have been good. This is the perfect color. Like, this is the exact color I wanted. I love when that happens. That's fair. Sleep is good. Get the bubbles. Off. Let that dry. Yeah, Miss Marvel looks good. Moon Knight has been surprisingly extremely good. The last episode was a little weird, but the cinematography and the way that show is shot is just absolutely incredible. I saw the trailer for Miss Marvel and it looks good. I saw the trailer for Thor: Love and Thunder, which looks so fucking good. I have half a mind to just name this decade the Taika Waititi's, because like he is absolutely fucking slaying right now when it comes to like acting and directing. Also, if you haven't watched Our Flag Means Death, please do. It is genuinely a very good show. All right, you done yet? I think I can just work a little. Man, like I said, Taika's just having a field day with the stuff that he's doing. When I found out that Our Flag Means Death was partially directed by him, I was like, this is gonna have some What We Do in the Shadows vibes, and I am here for it. Like I said, we'll just rename it the Taika Waititi's. For the carapace, I'm gonna do rigid leather because this is like the most red brown I have.
Drop the bass.
I'll probably go back over that and the red again just to bring it back out, because I think I just did a little bit too much on the dry brushing. Go back over it with Ard Coat just to give it like a gloss on the carapace. Because, you know.
probably definitely go back over that with the red. Just to help bring it back out. Oop, too much.
Looks good so far, though.
Damn. I feel like he's already getting close to done, and it's only been 40 minutes. Or 50 minutes, sorry. I missed a lot of spots with the red, so instead of going back over it with the contrast or the speed paint, I might just actually get a red in there. Come on, crimson. I feel like the dragonfire red might actually be best for this.
Yeah, it's bringing some of the red back out pretty nicely. Also helping dilute things a little bit on the bright side when it comes to the little feats, which I'm not upset about. Need too much of that white. No, it's okay. I'm also focused on painting and not saying much, so I'm right there with you. I think one of the next upgrades I'm going to do is just doing a complete paint overhaul. Starting to run out of paints anyways, and I want to try a different brand, so. Try some Vallejo minis or some Vallejo paints. Hey, getting distracted by art's never a bad thing. Don't apologize. We should do that soon. It's been a while since we painted together.
No, I do not want that on my first game.
Okay. never a bad thing. That was like a big, the loot this month, the like big piece was a like a Colosseum style fighting pit. I'm debating whether I want to print it out or not. Go over a little bit of it with the red, because again, hey, non-dairy ice cream is fucking phenomenal. We have a Ben & Jerry's, like, shop on Pearl Street near us, and it has been a godsend.
Alright. Now I need... brush. I actually don't have a reason to go to Pittsburgh anymore, by the way. My buddy got accepted into med school at Yale. So I'll be out Connecticut area. But I'll probably still come stop by. Who knows, maybe FSU will go play Pitt at some point and I'll just go up there and visit you guys.
That actually, I've been thinking about that a lot. I think that people should start doing that as a, like, just in general. Like, anybody who does printed minis or anything like that, kind of like how Epic Encounters does it, where they give you everything that you need. I may be in Connecticut at some point. I don't know if it's going to be this year, because we have our wedding. But all of my friends will be in the Connecticut area. Like, my best friends will be within a one-hour triangle of each other. So I will probably be in Connecticut at some point. I don't know when, but at some point it will be. Yeah, I will definitely let you guys know when we're doing it. Obviously, we probably won't be streaming when I do that, so you guys will be very well aware of when that happens. Also, this music reminds me, if you haven't watched our unboxing video for the Van Richten's minis, please do. My buddy David made the music for it, and it is... it's a bop. Damn it. All right, now to let it dry. That was quick. I'm getting too good at this. But while I'm here, I might as well work on this. If it's dried yet. It hasn't fully dried. Let's see, do I have anything else that's midway? Like I said, I think the kobold one I really liked. You can never have enough kobolds. I have to look at what else they have, because I haven't looked at a lot of the sets that they have. I know they've got the orc. I know they have a few adventuring ones. The Balrog looks pretty cool. I like bigger minis, so I might do one of those. Yeah, Scorpion on a Stick. I love the little additions they made to, like, the monsters. I'm considering backing the Matt Colville book that's coming out, just because it has, like, variations on standard creatures. But I'll have to see. I'm also gonna throw some yellow in here because I'm looking at pictures and most of them have like a bit of yellow. So. I'm just gonna lightly brush it on. Thank you.
beauty of this is if I don't end up not liking it, I can always just reprint one. Honestly, this yellow looks pretty cool.
So it looks more like a centipede now.
Make the mandibles yellow too.
Sorry if it's not on screen.
Doing my best.
Look at that. Look at that guy. Look at it.
on this base. Since he is pretty much done.
Whoops. Don't do that.
Ahoy! Welcome in. Just kind of finishing up things. Working on some bases that I forgot that wanted you open that. Sorry. It is fun. That's too much paint. This is the base for the Sphinx that I painted a few weeks ago. Because the centipede is pretty much done. But thanks for coming in and joining. I appreciate it. It's good to see you again. I bet that's the... No, because I didn't do hard code on this. So I really don't know what that is. But I don't mind it, honestly. Fair skin on that. That should be good. Mm-hmm.
getting better at doing terrain and getting it to look the way I want it to. I think it's just coming with the fact that, like, I'm understanding my color palette better. So I was like, ah, it's like a Sphinx, and the base is like Egyptian themed. So I want it to look like sandblasted sandstone, and I think I did a pretty decent job at doing that. Like, it looks like stone. And the sand around it adds a nice texture to it. And she looks cool on it because she is... Oh, that's right, I wanted to do green on the eyes. That's why I grabbed this. Don't need a lot, just need a little. Green to match the eyes of the Sphinx. Because I like bases that match their minis. I think it adds a cool flavor. How are you gonna situate on here? I think it's like this. Yeah. Oops. That's probably too much, but that's okay. That dry to the base.
I was waiting for it, yeah. Went to the gym today, so it wasn't arm and chest day, but it was back and shoulder day. Alright, and now comes to the portion of our stream where we chill. I'm just gonna wait for this to dry. That's true, I've gotta work on that. That's something that I'm trying to get better at, is having more... Oh, viewer engagement. It's hard. I've just been so busy with everything. Oh, God. My back.
gracious.
Yeah, but I'm actually pretty happy with the way this guy turned out. I was a little worried at first, but I'm getting halfway decent at, like, highlighting and making things look how I want them to, so... My hair is also getting so long. I can put it in a ponytail. Well, I'll work on that. One of the other things we're probably going to do soon is another community goal where we try to put as many points in, and I'll paint another big mini like I did with the Dragon Turtle. Because I enjoyed it and I want to paint bigger things more. I feel like it'll give me a nice boost in helping understand how to paint bigger things and doing a little bit better at the detail. But that'll definitely be something coming up. I'll work on stuff this weekend because I don't have D&D tomorrow. We haven't played in like 4 weeks, but everyone's been a little busy, so yeah. All right, well, that's really all I've got. I don't really have anything else to do. I got some stuff I got to work on, but I have to do that off stream because it's a surprise. That'll do it on my front. Thank you guys for joining tonight. Thank you for coming and hanging out with me. I really appreciate it. I'll get something a little bit more difficult for next Monday, so that way we can, you know, actually try and take the 2 hours it takes to get it done. I've got some things that I've printed out that I could work on, but I want to print off some of the stuff that I got from loot because I want that to go towards good things. So, that'll do it for me. Final spiel for Tan the Night. Like I said, thank you for joining. If you aren't already following the channel, please do. Trying to get to 200 or to 500 followers by the end of the year. We're almost at 250. We're like, I think, 18 away right now. Yeah, follow us on our socials at Stream of MT on Twitter, TikTok, and Instagram. Join our Discord. It should be in chat. If you have the financial ability to, or you have a Amazon Prime subscription, you can subscribe to the channel. You get emotes and stuff like that. I'm working on getting more stuff for the community. And yes, Ro, thank you for reminding me because I almost forgot. I should say this on stream. If you want to see me get absolutely blitzed out of my mind, like super high on Wednesday for 420 and play some Hollow Knight, be here. Same bat time, same bat channel. It's gonna be fun. I'm excited. I love the game and we're getting into the end part of it, so it's gonna be fun. But that'll do it for me for now. Let's see if anyone else is on right now. I want to raid someone. We're going to raid Mini Terrain Domain. So stick around for a little bit. But thank you for joining tonight. I will see you all on Wednesday. And yeah, have a great night. Peace.